And good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to CappingTV for coverage of the WAN-Slide CSGO tournament. My name is Chris Yavis, joined by Flippy Bits tonight. And for our first game, our semi-final, it will be Exsto Gaming taking on Why Are You Crying, although effectively they are the full Paradox roster. They're currently doing vetoes as we speak. I can tell you that the first two maps taken away were Overpass and Nuke. And it will be, I believe, Mirage, the first map here. I'm not sure about the second, though.
No, first map was actually Train and then Mirage.
Okay, I've been lied to by the chat.
GoTV chat always breaks. Normal. That's about what we expect. Counter-Strike 2020, it still doesn't work half the time.
Yep. Thank you, Valve. But it should be a pretty decent game. Obviously, Paradox being Paradox, I would say they should go close to winning out. But I'm saying that exists. So they have a couple of good players here: Spard, Typer, Exela, Matty S, and of course James, who most people will remember back from his immunity days. They have a shot. Let's put it that way.
Oh, they definitely do, but you can't downplay what Paradox have been doing lately all across Counter-Strike. They've been absolutely putting up numbers, putting in work as a roster. So they're going to come out, guns blazing, trying to get these beautiful prizes tonight.
Yeah, a fair few nice prizes available, but yeah, Paradox pretty much on the cusp of top five, or some people will say they're on top five, but that last spot is up for grabs, effectively, for the moment, for my opinion. But yeah, they should be looking good. I say this phrase a lot when I'm doing my Rocket League casting, but I think it's applicable here. There's a very strong possibility that Paradox might just be a class above Exsto here. If that's the case, well, you never know. Train and Mirage might go past very, very quickly.
They definitely could, but one thing I have noticed, Paradox, Why Are You Crying here tonight? Their CT side on Train is phenomenal.
It is.
We could definitely see a quick game coming out here.
Yeah, definitely. I would probably say that CT side Train is probably one of the best in the region, actually. Probably Renegades might have the slightly better one. But yeah, Paradox are definitely top two in that regard for CT Trainer. It's going to be hard for Exsto to break through here, so I'm fully expecting Paradox to take up the first game, but the second one, that's probably where they will be most vulnerable. Mirage, obviously the infamous pug map, there's been too many occasions where games you think that are going to be straight wins here in Oceania just turn into multiple OTs because it's just Mirage. You get some very lucky aim, and that's how many upsets go in this region.
Well, we even just saw it right before this. Why You Crying played, I think it's Yesha Guta?
I think that's how you pronounce it, yeah.
That map went 25-23 on Mirage.
Yeah.
So it's definitely a map that can be hard fought from both sides. And I know both of these teams are not going to give up.
Yeah, especially Exsto, though. They're going to try their best. They're going to be in for the fight for the long haul. And, well, the question is, can they spruik an upset here or there? Or are they just going to roll over to the might of Paradox? Or, in this case, Why Are You Crying tonight? Players starting to rejoin the server here after the veto on Dust 2. We're just waiting on two of the Exsto players to get on side. But, well, you guys all know my prediction here, but Flippy, what do you think is going to happen here in this semi-final?
I think we're going to see a 2-0 from Why You Crying. It's favoring them heavily. They got a map they're really solid on, and they have the talent to win the aim duels on Mirage, which is so crucial in that map. I think it's going to be a hard-fought map on Mirage, but I do believe they're going to come away with it.
Indeed. Just a quick update for Exsto. It looks like James is not playing. I believe Spider is the replacement there. Farslap was one of the other players in the original squad. There were a few roster issues earlier today, with WAN-Slide with New Zealand players being unable to play. So we have seen a fair few emergencies having to come through here, but I suppose the biggest fixes in that regard would have to be Why You're Crying, because they've effectively got their full Paradox roster up here, except for maybe Nexa.
Yeah, he is really the only one that is not a normal player with the rest of these guys, but they're still good friends, you know, they still play with each other, so it's not like a complete stranger joining the team. It's someone that they know, that they're comfortable with hanging out with, at least.
Yeah, and that's going to be massive for Why You Crying, or who are effectively Paradox from this point onwards. We're probably going to be switching that in between, well, whenever we speak, really, just a heads up on that, so if you ever get confused. But yeah, players almost ready here. We're just waiting on the final few from Exsto to ready up in the server. We should be underway here. Exsto, though, they will be siding on the CT side, it, I presume, so... Yeah, they will be able to deny Paradox their full half on CT, which is ideal. But yeah, it's still going to be an uphill battle for them.
Going to be a battle no matter which way we go. We're getting right into train, and it's time for Counter-Strike.
Definitely is. WAN Slide semi-finals about to begin here on train. Exsto taking on Why You Crying / Paradox as the time runs out, and we are underway for this best of three. It looks like it will just be a very slow early push over towards Kitchen and Brown Halls here. Not too much surprises being pulled out by Why You Crying. Pretty standard start to the pistol round. But we do see Danger just landing at the other end of Brown. He might go with this rookie kill too, but he's been spotted out, so fast up. And Maddie able to do a little bit of damage, forces him out of position. He's now over towards the rafters. Bomb still hovering around the ladder though, so a couple of options here for Why You're Crying.
Just playing the information game, it's kind of what you really like to see on a map like train on this T side. And Maddie S going to go ahead and open things up, spamming down Danger with that Glock. Type R with that long range, traded out immediately by Versa though.
Oh, look at this. Oh, the Donka, he has dual, he's the man. He has one, yes! Two, three! Can he get a fork? He has to reload, but oh my god, the madman will eventually be taken down by Star Slap. He will get punished for his transgression, however, as the Donka, the man with the jewelies, will get the opening for Why You Crying. The names are screwed up on the server, but we don't care. 102 Paradox, Why You Crying.
And that hold for Donka, that's the kind of stuff you love to see. Just already breaking out, having fun with it. You can't always be serious in Counter-Strike. Sometimes you gotta just let your hair down, have a little fun, hang out with the boys and spam some bullies. And he's not stopping now. He's got the MP9.
So, yeah, remember when I said you won't see a full half of Why You're Crying on CT side? I was wrong there. I was baited out by the server. 2-0 up for him now here. And, oh boy, well, that ideal opportunity for Exsto. It's just been flushed down the toilet here as, well, Why You're Crying? They are just, well, they're just showing their girth at the moment.
Yes, we do apologize that, it is backwards, the name, team names.
And this is why you join the right side of the server as Ekal and Vedonka and Danger as well come in for yet another beautiful
Danger just
feast
fell to his death.
Yeah, oh my god.
So did Vedonka! This is doable!
Yeah, Tiger gets one, he's very low. Nexa will just get the kill on 1 HP. And then Bro comes out there from the side of Why You Crying. They definitely were nearly crying there, but they're still somehow up 3-2-0. Bloody hell, though.
That is not what you want.
Nope.
They are starting to build a strong economy for their CT side, so it's not that terrible. They were probably looking to upgrade rifles anyways, knowing that YU or Exsto is going to be buying up into this.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, but those two players who died at over towards Pop Dog obviously did have the MP9, so it didn't really matter too much here. But now we get to seeing, we are now seeing some more traditional Counter-Strike gameplay here as both teams decide to go for setups on the first rifle round. A pretty top standard one here from YU Crying, a player towards Ivy, two on the A, two on the B. Bomb still hovering around T-spawn here, just towards the entrance of Kitchen. Not too much to report early on here, as we do get to see Typer though, start a little push up here, although he could find himself in between a rock and a hard place. Next up, just waiting for the AUG. This man believes he's back in 20, outside of 2020, and he'll get punished for a quick trade, however, from Versa, as the bomb will now get picked up by Matty S. And he'll take it over towards T-Con here. Setup starts to come through. Molotov comes from far side, but he immediately gets to delete it there by E-Carl. Versa as well, doing damage. E-Carl, easy kill there onto Spud. He's got one more to find. He'll get the trade with Versa. 4-0 up to YU Crying.
What a start to the game, and that's exactly what you need on the CT side. Even with the new economy changes, everybody starting out with that 1900 loss bonus. It's hard to build an economy on the CT side, and they've done it. I mean, it's round 5, they are down with just 2 SMGs after all the deaths they've had in the past couple rounds. But still, they have the AK, the M4, the AWP in their hands, the kill onto Alex there, and the second there from E-Cole.
Yeah, E-Cole keeps his glorious orb. He should be able to find another one, although Typer does get timed out. Somehow some... never mind! That is beautiful from E-Cole, as he somehow finds Typer through the smoke and the wall. Down to a 2v5. Only one bit of armor there for Matty S. E-Cole just showing the disrespect with the spam. Matty S might be able to find a kill onto Badonka. Will be able to. Brings him to a 3v1. Once again, causing a little bit of damage on to the side of YU Crying's economy. Although, 55 seconds remaining here. Doesn't look too likely that Exsto are going to get the opener here in the 5th.
With just 6 HP and a dream, he's going to lose his head to Nexar's USP. And it's going to be a 5th very quickly. Or why are you crying here in the semifinals?
And this is what we were saying earlier. Why are you crying, or in this case, Paradox's CT side is definitely one of the best in the region here. And, we are seeing it in full flight right now, even with a few what-the-hell moments being sprinkled in here for good measure.
It wouldn't be Counter-Strike without those moments.
Oh, definitely. Would not be, especially in Australia, as we do see a trade there for Spubba. Danger with the MP9, he finds one, we'll have to reload. He's going to try and find a second, he does have 3/4 health. We'll get that until Passup will eventually bring his Reign of Terror to it, the end. Picks up an AK now, so 3v2, definitely doable for Exsto, but Nexa, the only player on the B side here. Versa over toward Z-Con, and Ekel just hovering around T-Con, so he's going to be in a great position to get the spray down. Two players taken out within a blink of the eye, and that's going to be why you're crying 6-0 up, as the names have finally switched correct.
Yes, they are. I was about to mention that, actually, and they're just making it look easy.
Yeah.
Like, they're just hitting their shots, and they're keeping the economy of Exsto in check. Even on the gun rounds, Exto's unable to really find any value in anything that they've got going in Badonka already. Straight up mill, danger to follow him up, but also traded out. But how has Eco gotten here?
He's made the quick runner popped off. Bombthorn will come in for Matty S here. First of the evening for him here, so every possible. He needs to get this dig or can only find one shot, as Versa will take him down. 3v1 now, type of the only man left standing. He's making his way through Z-Connector. It's going to be a hard play for him, though. There's two players down there. Next alone, taken down. Every chance, but E-Carl says no. Gives him the quick scope, and that's 7-0 up to why you're crying.
And now, it's going to be a huge problem for Exsto to counter this economy. 7 rounds in and they have yet to lose a single one. They are definitely going to be hard pressed to try and rebuild this anything against this.
Yeah, especially when Ecult's on fire with the AWP as well. 11-1-3 for him at the moment. He is mere unstoppable here. It's just like him playing in FPL half the time. And, well, when Ecult's on fire, it's very, very hard to stop him as Nexar. We'll get the cheeky kill over towards Ivy. Has been spotted out. Does a fair bit of damage as we do see Danger being taken down with the MP9. He's just going for frags. And why not at this point? But look at that. Perfect positioning from Badonka. We'll quickly take down Matty S and we'll stop the Ground Wars play for now. Although, in saying that, now there's only a ruse as Ecult. We'll have to use utility over towards T-Con. Has molly'd up Fast Lap. Alex, though, he's in a very good spot to take him down, but look at Ecult. He's going to try it, but we'll be to his own disadvantage here. Versa, though, we'll get one kill. Versa knows where Spud is, but we'll be taken down. There's now a 2v1 here. Nexa only on 1 HP, so you might see Brazil come out. Fast Lap able to take down Nexa. And now, Badonka, 12 HP, he's in Pop Dog. It's going to be completely expected from Fast Lap. Takes him down, Brazil achieved 7-1 up. Still 2 Paradox.
What a round. They finally managed to get one on the board for themselves, and it's been a hard road up to this point thus far. Round 8, took them 8 rounds. They got one of them. Now, can they work off this momentum that they've started, continue to put rounds back-to-back? Because one round is not going to help them in the grand scheme of things. And here we are with the disrespect again. Just straight up, do not stop. Ecult with the AWP actually gets taken down.
Sure. And they're just running in. They literally just don't care. They're just going in as hard as they want. They're getting frags, but they've lost 3 of their own number here. Danger with the AWP. He's in a bit of a harder place here. Nexa is trying his best to get 1-2 from T-Con. He's able to do the damage. Quickly swings around for a Typer. He's able to bring it into a 1v1. Knows exactly where Danger is on 69 HP. But Danger has made his way over towards E-Box. He's been flashed out, though. He's somehow still alive. Typer's going to go for the blade. Locks on the head. And Exsto gets a second.
And now they have kind of damaged the economy. That all-important CT economy of Why You Crying isn't the best at this very second, but they are rebuilding back, especially with these two SMGs on Badonka and Danger. It can very quickly get back right into their hands.
You know how lethal they can be as Versa actually does damage to that Deagle. They're very lucky not to find the head, but yep, here comes the MP9 rush. Badonka, oh, the flick! That is disgusting as Ecult all finds Alex, but trying his best to tap down his opponent. He'll get dropped down. And we'll be able to find Ecult at the very least. Might be able to get the bomb part as well with the rest of his team joining him through ground halls. So, every possible looks as so to go. 3 on the Trollers, but he's about to get flanked out here. Easy frag for Danger. And yes, he has to be so careful now, but Danger, he's on a bit of a tear here. Versa will eventually take down Versa, and just like that, Exsto's run has been stopped dead in its tracks. Paradox onto 8.
And as I was saying, they have to get control back into their economy. They just come out swinging. The Eagle's blazing. MP9's flying around the corner. Threw a molly as well. It wasn't just that he flew around the corner. He ran through a molly to get that kill in T-Con.
And he got the flick onto the head as well. That is, yeah, that was just completely disgusting there from Badonka. There's some other way of putting it, really.
That's just Badonka things at this point. Barslaff, though, what a quick opener. The spray down on the blind jumping player.
Good for Fast Lap here. We'll give Exsto a few more options for the A site, although they're changing their time here, not willing to rush it up. Next point contact might be over towards Ivy, although Typer isn't risking to play just yet. Nice boost coming out here from Alex, trying to see if anyone's up there on the carriages, but will not get spotted out at the moment. Paradox will. As many yes, we'll start. Push out here, although he decides against it, makes his way straight back up Hot Dog. It looks like this might be a ground horse play, although you do have a player playing in rotation at the moment, and that being Ecult with the AWP. has the first exit out of Brattles inside as all that is not a good wide swing there from Badonka. Will be quickly taken down, and just like that's all up to the AVP to try and get the one man hold on the B side. Rotations are coming through here. He's just going to hold on the other side of Planet Carriage here. Igalo, he's able to find one with the Orcs, but though, he gets a trade out. Fast up has got it out first. Will eventually get sprayed out just like that. All up to Nexar. He's just caught in between a rock and a hard place. Can't do anything from Road Carriage and will be eventually taken down. Exsto up three.
Ikon already taken the lead, obviously, at halftime. Once this half does finish up, just not a whole lot to say. It's just non-stop action. They did slow down a little bit in that round, which I liked to see, because after all the aggression they've been pushing to kind of just breathe, they could actually throw them off. But Alex not being thrown off at all as he finds the head of danger with that MAC-10.
I mean, Deja has just been running into every single choke point available this game, so wasn't that hard to see him doing it again. Alex will find another one until Badonka eventually takes it down. Matty S, oh, he gets very lucky. Badonka goes down, and he'll get Punisher as well. Matty S able to get the kill. Nicole taken down. Once again, all up to Nexar. Gets one nice shot, but can't find the second. Will be taken down by Matty S. Bomb plant just gets in. As Exsto starting to make a bit of a comeback here.
A little bit of a comeback, yes, but they do need a whole lot more to bring themselves back into this game to really keep it competitive. As they are still down four rounds coming into the very last few rounds of the half, and with just the Scout Deagle by coming out for Why You Crying, the sole MP9 on Badonka, and he's on that B site all alone. And unafraid, I would hope.
Well, he's playing pretty middling positions there with the B side, as all that is sharp from Farsight. Quickly takes down Nexar. And that will open up the A side just a little bit more here. Free players, though, still just hovering around the carriages as Matty S trying to scope out B for a ground horse. We'll get one swipe down on to the lower paths, but
that one smoke has pulled two players off the A site.
It has. Although,
but with the positioning from Danger, he knows that they're not coming A.
He definitely does. He's got all the audio cues from Kitchen here, so one rotation will stick. Ecole still hovering over towards Heaven here, just in case of the fake out, but I don't think we'll be seeing that one here. 40 seconds remaining, all but committed to the B site here. Exsto, as they will eventually make the push down here. Spud first one out. Pass up, just waiting for the connect to play as Type like it's an easy frag versus to take it down as well. This round all but in the bag for Exsto as well. What can Danger and Ecole do? They can get one frag at the very least, so you do burn up slightly, however. Only about 120 HP remains in between. I mean, Ecole gets one, but will be eventually taken down by the frag. And that's going to be the round all but sewn up here. Danger just looking for some consolations, but Exsto will move on to five here. Closes the gap down to three.
And another crucial round for them as Danger getting taken down by Typer. They need these last two rounds to stay in this match. A upset here on Why You Crying could do wonders, not just obviously for the map score, but for their mental state as well. Going up against a roster this strong, you know, you're probably coming in a little bit on the back foot, just thinking that you might not have as much of a chance as you think you do.
There's also different sides to that story here, as Badonka does get one. We'll be tacked down to 40 HP, so it has to fall down Smokey Ecole. Going for the risky play will pay off perfectly, and that pretty much shows what I was about to say. Why Are You Crying? They're taking this as a meme, throwing away and putting it as a Molotov. Will get denied by his own smoke. Somehow still alive in Pop Dog. Will eventually be taken down outside the doors as Versa will pop death as well. And Spud, he's on fire. Takes down Nexar as well. The round just quickly turns on his head. It's all up to Danger making the rotation from B. Looks like he is going to go through CT spawn. This is bad for Exsto. They don't have bomb at the moment. So one or two frags this round will turn on its head once again.
There's one person you can count on in these types of situations. It is dangerous. He's going to go ahead and pick up the first. Recover that rifle. And both these players, very low HP. He's got the second. One more to find.
He's only on 27. He's on 21. No, and he will get taken out by the Molotov. Well done there, by Spud. We'll get the trifecta and we'll close the gap down to 6. But this is what I was saying earlier. It feels, I mean, it doesn't feel like, it's obvious. Why are you crying? I'm really taking this seriously here. They're showing a fair bit of disrespect to Exsto, so sure, they're getting the rounds, but at the same time, they're getting the rounds quite cheap, to be honest.
Oh, definitely. The ones they have won, it hasn't been from, you know, this solid team Counter-Strike that...
It's been from Why Are You Crying Throwing, really.
Yeah, it's been from almost... pugging. They're out here having fun, you know, it's never a bad thing to see players having fun in Counter-Strike. But it's almost disrespectful sometimes to see that kind of play in a tournament.
Yeah, and speaking of pugging, I think this is getting towards about level 6 basic levels of pugging here, to be completely honest. I mean, yeah, Paradox, they are the better team here. They have been able to get a fair few good frags with the weaker weaponry, but it's just really, it's just them having a laugh, having a meme. No other way of putting it, really, as Nexar looking to try and take out Typhus, spots him out, will eventually get 1-2, how do you do? And, yeah, just like that, 5v3. Last round, the half. This half has actually flown past, this has gone very, very quickly, all things considered here, as Knocker finds one, finds a second, can't find the third, the orb will eventually take him down, but Versa will eventually finish things off, mine ticks, it would end, but it could have been a lot more for Paradox.
It definitely could have. I feel like a lot of those rounds, if they just kind of played off each other a little better, held angles together, especially on those deagle buys, that scout, try and play the tag them and bag them a little more. Give them just a few more rounds in the bag and try and close this thing out just a little bit quicker.
Indeed, as I have once again got the scoreboard bug here, so I will be slightly annoyed for the next minute or so. As we do see Typer trying to find a frag, maybe Esso will pick up the first of the second half. As the plays on the A side has failed very early on here, two players quickly taking down a T-Con and Pop Dog. For the side of Why You Crying, make it that a second as well over to Pop Dog. 5v2, just like that. Exsto looking pretty nice here on the pistol round. I like that all change, especially with Bunker over towards Ivy. Will be spotted out though by the two-man flank. And just like that, all up to next up. The bot frag, I can't do too much, unfortunately, for him. And just like that, Exsto picks up the opener in the second.
And a crucial pistol round as well. Once again, CT economy, such a rough thing to deal with. And they managed to take the pistol round, which is going to start them off on the right foot into the second half. And now we see three Tech Nines coming out for Why You Crying. Three Tech Nines, the Deagle and the MAC-10. No bomb plant either, so they're just fully committed into this round. And they're just going to mow down Alex as soon as they can. Get these Tech Nines and that MAC-10 already taken down, though. And...
it's doing damage though. It's into the 3v3 against the Masters and the Scout. I'm saying that Typer, nice aim there to spray down Versa. Alex are taking down quickly, but oh, with the P250, that's disgusting right there. Gets the second as well. And Exsto, so they are roaring back in here. Only one behind now. Why Are You Crying? Who pretty much have to eco here. Well, I'm saying that. Ecal says hell to that. They're just going to buy.
This was a. Another example of that almost disrespectful take on the game, where they're just not worrying about economy. They're not worried about really playing off each other. And oh my god, that nade!
Made damage. We just saw about 3 bars just go from 100 down to very low in a matter of microseconds, really. Versa will be taken down as Typer nearly gets faded out here. Danger, what's he doing? Around E-Box, we'll get punished. As you see, one for Badonka. Matias takes an easy frag there. We'll get a double. No, Alex actually taking that kill there. Exsto now tied up here. But I suppose the paradox that is, like, as much as this is a tournament, this is probably not high on their priority list. You would have to say they do have bigger fish to fry at the moment, including such like LPL.
LPL, MDL, they got it all on their plate now, and they, like I said before, you know, they're having fun.
Jesus Christ, Farslap. Oh, he's having fun as well, though. Line will be able to get the kill, gets a second as well with the AWP. AK's up now for Why Are You Crying? And well, they will be able to get the bomb line here. Only two players remain. They're making their way around old bomb over towards A1 and 2. Although we do see Ecole making a rotation to Ivy. We'll be able to spot out Alex here with a hope. Flash comes through. They've been caught kissing, but Ecole will get the biggest switch this time around. Fast lap. Most players standing in 1v3. Ecole just giving Batonka a bit of how do you do right there. Rotation out comes from Fast Lap. I think he's not that bothered about the round here. He gets a nice little flick there on to Batonka. Ecole will be credited with the assist, but that bomb too far gone now. It will be Why Are You Crying, regaining the lead here, but yeah, this game turning into a bit of a meme fest.
Oh, that is sharp!
Jesus Christ,
oh
awesome.
My gosh.
I'm just seeing it up again. How has he got that? He's literally browned his pants doing that flick.
I don't think he planned on it. I think that was an accidental.
I think I was as well, because I just saw it on the Twitch stream, which is affecting my replay system, and oh my god, that was... Oh god, that's... Bloody hell, man.
A little too late to really have any impact, but... Still, you gotta appreciate a nice shot like that when it happens.
Yeah. You have to indeed here, as... But then, yeah, so when he gets a double, his teammate's being traded out in the process. Fast lap over towards the mine first. We'll be able to get the kill. Brings it into a 1v2 with Nexon once again, last man left standing here. He's caught in between a pretty tricky spot here. Not really plant at the corner, but Alex can always make the rotation around. Eventually, Pinsir is off. Oh, nearly gets the kill. Keeps it on 9 HP. But Nexon, he's up for the fight here. He's going to try and go for the 1v1 against Farslap. Won't be able to do it though, so he's going to make his quick escape. No, he actually goes up. He's still alive. Only 4 damage coming up from that shot from Farslap. And Exsto able to defy the odds time and time again in this 20th round. Still alive. And he's making his rotation over towards the B side. Farslap, is he going to read it? Almost does. Almost gets baited out. But he's actually going to go over on towards Pop Dog here. Gets... Actually, decent opportunity to bring it into 2 1v1s here. Next, just slowly making his way through here. But Farslap playing out perfectly at Z-Con. Takes him down with tied up once again.
Tied up at 10 apiece. We have a player on each side as well at 20 kills or above. And Matty S not too far behind, just sitting on 19. Ecole over on 18. So it's been a fairly high game in terms of frags, and Bud has a bison.
Can this game become even more of a meme?
I didn't think it could, but there's been a bison brought out.
Yeah, a bison brought out here to complement an AK and M4, a Thamas and an AWP. Frags going over towards Exsto Heroes. Why are you crying? Well, yeah, I don't know what they're doing at the moment here. They obviously don't have decode, but yeah, it's quite blatant to say they're not taking it seriously. I mean, I suppose it's understandable enough, but
Oh, Badonka!
Okay, Badonka. Okay, mate. He's still fragging out though. We know that for sure. Typo though, he'll be getting one trade. Can't get the second though. Next up, able to somehow get the second shot as well. Into a 1v2 now as Badonka has been taken down. Spide able to pick up nothing actually. He's onto a USP here. He's trying to give some disrespect over as well. We'll eventually pick up the FAMAS, however. As Nexar trying his best with the Deagle. One shot away from death, however. Spud should be able to get the rotation off in time. He's going to make sure of it. He's going to take the long way around. We'll get him in the back. And that will be Exsto in the lead for the first time tonight.
Wow, it really is the first time they have had the lead thus far. And not a moment too soon as we're getting into the last third of this game. Pretty heavily, and it's been neck and neck, really, since about round 7, when Exsto really started to mount that comeback into the first half. Ended it out on 9-6. Obviously not ideal, but they've proven they can come back from it. You know, we came into this kind of doubting them, but I think that was a mistake.
It was to a degree. I still think this game could have been done a long time ago if Paradox took it even about 10% more seriously, and they didn't just continue to do MP9 runs in our CT side, but...
Well, now we do see a full execute coming out from them, but it doesn't matter when Alex is hitting shots like that.
Yeah, he gets one, but look at that econ with the flick off, able to shut down at least one player, quickly reads the player from behind. Spider able to find one. Ekaldo holding a very close line. We'll be able to easily take down the shoulder peak. And just like that, it's all off the tie. I can't do much against Versa. Tie back up once again at 11-all.
11-all, and now we see Badonka and Farslap both on 22 kills. Badonka having 106 ADR to his name so far. He's having a fantastic game. There's no denying it.
Yeah, Badonka just doing Badonka things at the moment. He's keeping his team honest at the very least. As Eka, oh, nearly gets a shot off. Still get the nose cap, however. Very lucky that nose cap didn't fly into danger. He will not be able to find a second, however. Danger making the run with the MAC-10 here. Didn't have enough economy, to get up the AK. So this is a bit more of an unsandable SMG buy here as Badonka might get flanked out of here if he's not careful by Maddie S. Type. We'll get executed really there, and just like that, this round orbit over here, just like on the eco, can't do too much. Eco might be the frag out here as Danger gets a free twofer, gets 1200 bucks into his pocket. Eco will eventually catch up the round. It is damn near perfect from White Crying as they regain the lead.
Yeah, that MAC-10 really put in the work that round to bolster that T-side economy even more than it already is, because we see all these players at least 4,000 except Danger, and he's only $50 short of it. So it's economy's not an issue for them for at least one round after this.
Maybe it's two, depending on how many frags they get here. Just a straight-up pistol bum rush here. Versa able to find two frags, will eventually die for his troubles, although they are just rushing through Ivy here, so on to the A-shot. Round should be over now, although saying that, Valid pogs off with the AK, every possible for exist though, but I think Paradox and Marv just clicked back into gear here. They quickly find three on the trot now. We'll regain a 2-round lead at the end of this, as Danger finds another 600 bucks into his pocket. But yeah, this could be Paradox finally just saying, all right, we've had our fun, let's end this now and take this on to Mirage's Badonka. Has to be careful here, as the orb will not land.
Badonka?
And that's around in the
careful?
Back. I mean, yeah, him being careful, it hasn't really been a, careful has not been a strong point in this map here.
I haven't seen much careful out of anybody in this game from either side. They've all... They've all just been running around having fun, from both sides, really. I mean, that's what you get, though, a lot of times, especially when we've all been in lockdown for so long. You get people that just want to play games for fun.
Indeed.
And sometimes it's what you need, and once we do get back into the normal swing of things, we could see these players come back swinging heavy, swinging for the fences. But this
look
is where
Danger,
you
though. He just made his way straight on over to Ivy. He gets a twofer, but it might not be enough here. As Ekar, last man left standing with an AWP, 70 HP in a dream, gets one nice shot off. He's found another two spots out the head, unable to get it. Gets the deagle though, and just like that, it's all 1v1. He's back on top blue once again here, and he has to be very careful of Zekot, his opponent, with the AWP as well. Has to know he's around Z, surely, but Farslap, he's actually going to go for the long con play. He's going to make the rotation over towards Pop Dog. But if Ekal plants this correctly, that rotation should be shut down quite effectively, as Yep, fast lap. Over towards the ladder now, but look at this. Is this going to be my games over my games here? E-Carl just making his way over towards the A corridors. I think he actually might be going B here. He is going B, so fast lap. He's gone before the mind games, but he's just been out mind games by E-Carl, as he's just going to get a free entry onto B. Or maybe not, though.
I'm so confused by this round.
This is a 5,000 IQ play here, though. Oh, no, this is not looking good. That's a miss from Fastlap. Will allow E-Carl to get the bomb down. But now, does he have the balls to pick? He makes his way over towards the nest. Will quickly send himself back around. Flash comes through. E-Carl just being spotted out. He's still white as a dove, but he knows exactly where his opponent is now. Can he get the 1v3? We'll find out very shortly as he spots out the side. Can't get the shot to land, however. He's just trying to waste time. He does have the AK. He's finally pulled it out here. But Fastlap, can he get it? He can't get the noscope. He has to stick. Gets the fake out. No kit, no clue. Time sticks away. E-Carl doesn't even need to get the last kill for the 1v3. As Why Are You Crying move on to 2 away from victory in map 1.
I believe you mean 3. Oh no, it did. It just takes it a while to update. I forget how Counter-Strike works sometimes with in-game assets. That it doesn't actually update the score until the beginning of the round.
Yeah, like, you would think it would be when the bomb goes off, when it's defused, or whenever.
Yeah, that's one thing I never understood.
Speaking of not understanding things here, Paradox have just returned back to the bum rush, and, yeah, they've just lost 4-4, only one trainee. E-Carl last man left standing once again, quickly taken down, and, we are back to our regular schedule. What the hell is this?
Yeah, Matty picks himself up a nice little hat trick there. Pretty 3 clean kills, and it's exactly what Exsto needs to stay in this game. However, this is going to be the moment of truth for Why You're Crying, as they're on the back foot with their economy now, as this is their last buy for at least a couple rounds. Donka, though, not giving a care in the world.
Pass up. Also not really giving a care there. Taking down the poor next over towards Brown Horse. Make the quick rotation over towards Econ as well here. So they're expecting something over towards the A side. It's well founded as Alex finds one. Can he find a second? He's a little bit slow for that one there as Manny S. He makes a rotation around after, well, everyone falls down there. It's all up to Versa, and he's over towards the top end of B. So, yeah, that's just happened again.
He's just wondering where his team was, and he just did a 360 and then sprayed down far slap.
Yeah. That's...
I think that right there is this map in a nutshell. Just that one shot.
Yeah, pretty much. Another way of putting it. Versa 1v3. He's going to very least try and take down Spud. We'll be able to, but Alex knows exactly where he is. This should be a free frag until... Actually, the light swing works out here. So Versa, once again, is a 1v1. He's able to make his way as well. D-Box, Manny S, he's just going to be able to push here. Should be able to spot him out. Gets the flick, takes him down. And Exsto, they nearly threw that away, but they'll eventually close it out. One round of difference now.
What? What a beautiful play, though, to even get those first, or those second 2 kills, really. You know, that one on the AWP and Khan, you kind of expected that one. He did have the angle advantage, and he was looking that way, even with the 360. Now, it does look like we're seeing Why You Crying bum rush and B fairly quickly. Being met heavy resistance, though. It's 4 players now coming over for Exsto.
Yeah, it could have been bad there for them, but they slowed it down at the right time, so they won't lose any of their numbers so far. E-Carlo might be caught in between Rock and RP, so Alex just quickly falls in. He's able to find one for the smoke, as his teammate will quickly trade him out. 3v2, a very doable 3v2, however, as the Donkey gets the bomb down, gets an AK as well to boot. But Spud will spray him down, all up to E-Carl, doesn't matter, quickly taken down, 14 all. We'll see the max 30 here in regulation. The question is, will we see in overtime?
I mean, is there anything that goes together better than Australian CS and overtime? It's a match made in heaven. And I don't mean the position heaven above A site. I have seen more overtimes watching Australian CS than I have in any other region.
Yeah, we are a region that is known for overtimes, and we might see it again when we didn't really expect it at all, as Eagle just makes a quick rotation down towards Pop Top. We'll get a spray out, but we'll find no one there, as Farsight just waits around the red carriage, just hoping someone to his loving arms won't be able to get it this time around, however, as this game just slows down once again here. Both teams just trying to feel each other out, trying to find the opening. As we do see the stock standard play coming out from my crying here, one over towards Ivan and everyone else spread out over towards Brown Horses. Typer gets a free kill there on it to Badonka. Rotations will be going through immediately though, as Matty S will get spotted out by Nexa and will lose the duel against the Galil. A play now starting to come out here as Ekal taken very low. We'll take Alexander 22. However, in the meantime, Ekal having to go on top, trying to play bait. Will lose his life for it for no real trade off here as an XR goes on a wide swing, will get punished as well, just like that. 2v4. That was a bit of server lag there, so that could indicate the end. We'll find out shortly as Fast Up finds one. Can he get the second? Has to reload. Where's his teammates?
Oh my!
First up. 1v2, both players very low. Doesn't matter. Exsto picks up the 15. Why are you crying? They should be crying right now, considering what we were predicting at the start. And so they have to go to overtime if they want to win.
I just gotta say, those two shots from Versa there, those two...
They were sharp.
Good God. Those were absolutely insane. Crispy.
Yeah, they definitely were, but unfortunately for Versa and his team, they've been punished for their transgressions here against Counter-Strike Gods. Nexa able to find a one. But they only lose a deal here, so
Typer.
Not the worst.
Typer.
Coming out.
Oh.
Never mind, this game's over. 16-14.
Alright, I mean, I guess that's how it goes. Sometimes when GoTV decides to change before we're ready. So.
Yep, so. Yeah, and that happened. 16-14 to Exsto. Definitely what we were expecting. And, I don't know what else to say. I mean,
there's not much we can say, but...
Yeah, I think the player said it in the server, so I think we're going to go to a break here.
Yep, we are going to take a quick break as everything ramps up here on Mirage, and we will be seeing y'all very soon. Hope y'all stick around. I'm Flippy Bits. That's Chris the Average over that way. And we'll see y'all back again on Mirage. All right, we are back into it. Getting things started here on Mirage, you know, the standard kind of formality of a knife round that is coded into so many games of Counter-Strike nowadays. But we are going to see this beautiful, beautiful match on Mirage, where map one was not what we expected here in the casting room.
Yeah, I think the less said about the our last map, the better, to be honest. So, as we were saying in our pre-game talk, we thought Exsto were going to be a decent enough chance here, because it's Mirage, it's the Pug map, it's, well, it's, everyone knows it, and this is gonna, and it's probably one of the maps that spooks the most upsets, but, well, we saw quite differently in the, first game of our series, as Typer will get the opening frag over towards the, entry on Tetris. Alex will find a second as well. We'll somehow get up, but two players make it through con. Fast up though. Nice sharp shot. He's down to one ball, so he's gonna have to quickly reload here, but it will be why you're crying. About to get pinsted out here. Next, last man left standing. Might be able to take out Alex. Leaves on 4 HP. We'll get wide swung twice. We'll eventually be taken down by Spud. Now we'll be open up over towards Exsto.
Very fast. Interesting play there coming out for Why Are You Crying, as they sent Deagle over to ramp alone with the Deagle in hand. And they died with all the utility still on their belt as well. So I'm kind of curious what the call was there. As nice little tag there on the Typer, but the nade there to return that damage right back.
Yeah. This is what we want to see from Paradox, though, coming out as... But he's playing aggro, finds one. Might be able to find a second as well. He's running long balls, though, so... He will eventually be taken down by the Deagle, although his teammates doing what they need to do here. Fast up, getting the kill onto Danger. Donka, you should be able to find one or two players on low HP. Fast up will be taken down. Ecarl makes his way over towards the Tigger booth. And just like that, 50 frags come out for the side of Y. Crying, Ecarl finishes it off. He gets himself a double along with Bursa. And that'll be us tied up at one all.
This is just AUCS in a nutshell to me. Rounds that shouldn't be won, because Exsto had every advantage going into that round. They had the rifles. Granted, it was just a FAMAS, but still, it was against Deagles and a couple other upgraded pistols. They had no business doing what they did in that round, but Matty has something to say about it in return. Two beautiful kills with that Deagle.
Yeah, two very good kills. Maybe enough to stop flying, however. Danger is low on 30 HP, although it has a Mach 10, so gets a few good shots off, has a chance. We'll be able to find one down over towards Africa. From a Versa on Cleon duty, finds one, the FAMAS, the second with the Deagle, just like that, while you're crying, into the lead.
Very quickly then, Versa, already just a few rounds in, 146 ADR on him. Not too much when, but Donka has a sawed off. Excuse me. He's going mid with the salt. If
yeah.
This, yep. my brain can't take this. My heart can't take this.
No bodily part should be able to take this. Flippy as Ecarl has made his way over towards kitchen. Oh no, this is going to turn into a bloodbath. Next, trying to find a spray now. Won't be able to here as Ecarl gets with a pack spray off. We'll still find the kills. One taken down, not being danger. But next, I will actually finish his things off. Boy, crying, 3-1 up. And well, yeah, that happened. We didn't see the sword off being put into use though.
We didn't. And that kind of makes me sad. I almost feel personally insulted that, you know, I didn't see a 3K with a sword off. But now it's looking like he just wants to bum rush ramp with a sawed off.
He's keeping it. He hasn't bought utility, so he's making a fine economic decision going for the rush. He has stopped, however, as Typer will be the first to die in this fifth round. A trade will eventually come through from Alex onto Danger. Sword off, making his way over towards T-Con. There is one player there liable, being Fast Lap. But Ecarl,
holding the line.
There's the kill onto the sword off, as Ecarl quickly takes down Spider towards Ticket Booth. Next, he's able to find one. Can't find a second just yet, as last man left standing does have the bomb in his possession. That being Mattias. Finds one kill. Just needs to hold on now for a minute, 5 seconds. Can he do it? Or he's going to make his way up to television. And we'll find out soon enough. Although, he's actually left it here, so
Interesting.
You have more
play.
Mob games being played here.
I wonder if he saw the bomb, because he was turning quite fast. He was just kind of spinning, almost spinning circles.
Well, it might still work out, and as he gets one, Badonka says, screw this, bomb rushes it over towards the A side, sends out the flash as well to boot. We'll give his position away eventually, but we'll get the bomb down. We'll still have the sword off in play. So it has to play a nice close angle, which definitely isn't ideal, but it's still working out for him here. As time ticks away, Matty S, playing patiently.
And the information.
Corners. Well, he has to be so careful because, I mean, look what his opponent has. He has a goddamn sword off. As Matty S will make the play. Oh, no. Oh, no. That is.
I thought we were about to see the knife there.
Yeah, I was expecting knife as well. I feel like in that situation, the sword off kill is even worse.
True, because you could have gotten the knife, and, you know, that's tilting enough, but to be like, hey, I could have knifed you, but here's a salt off to the head instead. That's just, adding insult to injury.
Indeed, as Spud! Well. Ooh, that's nice and sharp there, as Danger. Gonna look to try and find some retribution, takes down Typo and Spud. He's making his way over towards Unders, very viable for another frag yellow burst. I'm not gonna damage that. Takes him down to 68. But Danger will get 1-2 down. Eventually sprayed down by Versa though, Spud. So 3v2 only Deagles to work with. Every chance, I suppose, but one will eventually come down here for next up. Plants it ideally for Tetris. As he goes to the Y string, he says, screw that, gets Y. Can he find a second? Yes he can. And that'll be why you come crying up to 5.
And if they're still asking why they're crying, it sounds like that.
Yeah.
Where they just run in. Badonka has $15,000.
I mean, what is he? He didn't buy any utility when he had the sword off. He kept that sword off for 2 rounds.
Man. Now he's gone for the AK, but one of these AKs already taken out, and another. These alts coming out, I didn't even recognize that they had the double alt setup coming out. But on Mirage, it can be so powerful.
It can, even when you whiff a shot like that.
And the flash.
Much... Yeah, that was a bit of a yikes, but it's still looking pretty good for Exsto here. Gets the opening 2. Forces Wayo crying into that very hard play.
No!
Maddie! He's just had a massive, he's just destroyed him!
You can't just do that to people!
No, he can't, but Manny says, screw that, finishes off, he gets a triple, and what a round for Exsto! Somebody has better clip that, surely! Oh, God, Manny!
That was nothing but ops that round. Matty picking up 3, Force Slap picking up 2 with his. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, that was just... Oh god, that was... near orgasmic there from Matty S. There's no way of putting it,
He's probably sitting in there like, guys, I promise it was an accident. It happens. I promise. Can we get an admin in the server, actually, to take a look at this? Someone needs to check his computer.
Yeah, they need to make sure he does have word.exe installed, as Varslap will get some retribution for Typo's death earlier on. We'll be an A play coming out here for why you crying, as they look to try and make the Tetris play work. Ekel throws the bomb out here. He makes his way up high. Went to the rafters and into Palace, so he's in a very good spot here. No one rotating from behind, so he should have all lines in a pretty good 1v1 situation. But the bomb, just taking away here. Just so, taking the time for the rush here. We'll set up nicely for their opponents as Ekel just gets the one. Can he find a second? No, he can't. First off, we'll be sealing all the fragments. 1, 2, thanks about a third. And that will be why you're crying. Quickly pick up retribution from the last.
I thought they'd be coming into that one a little bit defeated after those alts just completely shut everything of theirs down. But no, they just came back, took over the A site, which hardly any utility. So now they're back on their confidence boost.
But they've spent so much to do it. If they lose this round, their economy's in the toilet. Sword off once again being picked up by Badonka. While we haven't noticed, he will get directly punished for it here. And once again, the orbs to the safe for being the saviors for Exsto. They find four for no cost. And well, there is one taken out, but Carl. He's just being spotted out, and Exsto picks up a third. Just like that.
Any more rounds they will need, but now I have faith they can get it. We came into it not quite sure if they could, but now that they've turned me. I'm an Exsto fan now.
I mean, the way that my crying are playing this, you do have to sort of give a few feelings over towards Exsto. They're actually going quite well. They're not doing as many memes, I would have to say, without organizer just coming in here and giving me a whack around the ears. Exsto definitely looking in a very nice spot as Versa. We'll be able to take down Typer, who only had a Famas, so not that much loss there. Exsto, they still have to be very careful because they lose this round, the double orbs are gone, so very crucial they pick up this round here. As Donker will get spotted out though, can't do too much with Sword Off in that situation. It does do 46 points of damage, so there is something for that, but not too much else. And just like that, 4v3 for Exsto. Why are you crying? Taking their time, and that bomb separated from the rest of their teammates.
Yeah, Why Are You Crying has really spread out this round, and it's kind of led to their demise. They've been beaten out in these 1v1s, and another one is the bomb is dropped with that shot from Farslap, and danger now on the lurk, able to find one though. Going to be up to Nexar to recover this bomb if he doesn't get taken down. Very low HP on him now. There's that AWP once again ringing out, and another Exsto pulling their fourth out.
Yep, that's a fourth for Farslap as well. So, yeah, this is looking actually quite dangerous, Wirecrow, you have to say. Sure, they have the two-round lead, but their buys have been, well, they think buys and only that. And now they've been punished onto an eco, or sorry, a hero gun play, as only Badonka able to pick up a rifle.
That's Typer. Able to find two fast ones.
Yeah, this round, just like that, done for. Exsto 5-6, one away from tying it up.
Been an interesting night. And now we see Why You Crying going for the buy again, actually. I don't know if I agree with that buy call here. Bringing out two AKs. It's definitely interesting, and this double play in con is actually beautiful because they heard that AWP fail out, but danger! Straight through the smoke, finds the head of Typer. With the MAC-10 as well, so the money off that is important. Now, one of the rifles, one of their few rifles on the ground at the feet of Farslap. No, it actually was able to be recovered.
Yeah, just able to get it in time here as Farslap. Oh, how does he not get that kill? Taking down to 15 HP. He's about to get pincered out though. He still finds one of the 5-7. Will eventually be taken down by Nexar on decent health, I suppose. But not more than 100 remaining for the side of While You're Crying. That nade won't do enough. Wasn't positioned well enough to get the kill there. As the bomb makes its way out of the nest. Makes his way onto the B side where there's only Matias to protect it there. He might get pinched out, however, but Badonka with the whip. He chucked off the Molotov. Matias doesn't read it. He focuses on Africa. We'll get punished for it. Bomb does get planted. Now, spot on a rotation here. We'll have to try and get the 1v2. Badonka playing a Well, he was playing a fairly ridiculous angle, but he's fallen back over towards get right. He's but, surely spotted out Nexa. Should be an easy frag for him now, but he's going to play it smart. He finds one. Can he find the second? Yes, he can! Spotted with an easy 1v2, and he will be able to tie things up at 6-4.
I feel like this has just been the story of this game. You know, why you can't get a solid lead, and then just...
And then they throw it.
Yeah, I mean, I don't want to say... In this day and age, putting the word throw out there is kind of a sensitive topic.
Don't worry, there's no gambling in this game. You can say it with impunity.
Yeah, but... Yeah. I've had to, make some reports lately, and it's sensitive. Some people, feel certain types of ways about it. But they have...
Oh, and that is...
They have just kind of... lost their edge that they start with. I'll leave it at that.
Tell you what though, Farsight definitely has not lost his edge. He has been on fire with that AWP. Gets the open once again for Exsto as they look to try and take the lead out here. Alex though, he will get punished for thinking it is the side of 2020 with the death, the AWP in his hand. Sager though, nice sharp shot along with Donka. Has Spud and Fast up though, gonna try and recover, 3v2, but fast up so low, you can't do too much when you're effectively glass cannon and your economy's in the toilet, especially with an AWP in your hand, so you're gonna do a smart thing, they're gonna peace out quickly as they can. Wavecrying will regain the lead, but Exsto though, still leaping at their heels as, ooh, that's a sharp shot.
Okay, first lap. I mean, I wasn't doubting you in the first place, but okay. I respect you. Ops on the side of Exsto have been on absolute fire this half. Both on Farslap and Mattias, just unbelievable shots.
Yeah, as they pick up the lead once again. I mean, these orbs have been very, very dominant. I mean, you just need to look at the scoreboard. Fast up and Mattias, two wheeling the big green guns. They're on top of the table for him, 17 and 12 respectively, as Versa just gets a free frag there. Typer was not expecting the early presence over towards ramp. Well, though, might be able to get some retribution. Fast out for Donka, but whiffs the spray and drops down as well. Ecole getting a little bit of damage onto his teammate there. As Danger, we'll chuck out the Molotov here. Bit of a scattered play coming out for the side of While You're Crying, but it's working out for him. 3v4 at the moment. Ecole and Fedonka holding the rotation here as the bomb makes his way over towards the B side once again. Pass up though, we'll miss the first. We'll get the second, although the bomb now safe to go towards B side here. The rotation will be called for Exsto though, so there is a chance for him to regain around once again, especially if Fast Up is hitting his shots as Ecole. We'll hear the flick of the scope. We'll get an easy headshot just like that, Alex. 1v2 has to do a lot, but he's about to get pinstered out. Next, he gets the frag. And While You're Crying, at the very least, picks up the half no matter what. Two round lead heading into the last of the first.
Is this the same scoreline we saw on train? Very close. Pretty much the exact same back and forth the whole time. While You're Crying starts off with a big lead. Hey.
Okay, Ecole.
I'm trying to say things and then they do stuff like that and I just lose all train of thought and ability to speak. Not that I ever had much ability to speak anyways, you know.
Yeah.
And it's a 9-6 half again. Exactly like we saw on train.
Indeed, so will we see Exsto pick up the lead in the second half? I suppose we'll find out in the next few moments as we flick on over.
If it ends up 16-14 again, I'm eating my shoe.
Hopefully it's made out of chocolate for your sake as we get the second half started very, very quickly here. I've got the scoreboard bug once again, so my vision will be impaired, but I can still figure out what's happening with the map, luckily, so it is going to be a 3-2 split towards low, as it seems. Not going for the early B play, so once again, it's going to be early focus A until Dennis gets here. A quick trade, though, over towards Maddie S. Now, this play quickly turns up to 100 here. Maddie S will get punished by Ekel, who's been sharp over the past few rounds. Pass up, though. He's going to force the pincer. Will eventually be taken down, Alex. But we'll find a frag. Needs to find a second. We'll be able to 1v2. Every chance. But next up, we'll eventually finish things off. And that will be the 10th round over towards Why You Cry.
And the dualies are covered on Nexar. That's the important thing, you know?
Yep.
That's what everybody loves.
Indeed, as we do see some upgrades here for Why You Crying, as you would expect. MP9s and all, Masters and M4. As that for Masters is going to make the rotation over. We'll spot out Alex, but Alex still alive for the moment. One kill for Eka. I'll make that a second. We'll be eventually taken down, and it's just going to be a butchering over towards our centro. So we'll eventually get the last two frags over for Why You Crying. So, oh, sorry, two frags will exist though. So it's not the worst of eco rounds there. We'll get some economy, but yeah, their opponents now five ahead here. They get the first rifles. It's still a dying time for them now, you would think.
Punch time now for Exsto, as we've seen what they do when they are in these situations where they're a few rounds down. Not quite so many where you can't come back, but like 5-6 rounds, and they have seemed to come back quite often. And just trades both ways to start this off. Already in the four very early on, and quite spread out, heading over towards the A site though. And we just see Why You Crying still with a lot of map control, and Versa hitting shots like that helps them out. Danger on top of Ticket finding one as well. Barslap finally finding one back in their favor. But the nade just off. Next are gonna finish it off with the M4 though. Now it's Spud gonna pick up the first. One shot through this Ticket booth could definitely take Danger down. Both these players very low HP. Danger with the timing though, and Why You Crying gonna grab their 12.
They get the 12, just like that. They have doubled their opponents rounds for now. Let's see if they can continue that on here as we approach 19. They're Exsto now on an eco, so we wouldn't expect them to do too much, although we have seen them pop off in these eco rounds before, as they're just going to make the rush down. There will be an early duel. It's going to work out. One, Spud! Two, how do you do for Spud? That is unbelievable for him now. And just like that, it's all up to Nexa Vizra and Danger to try and recover. Typer just spamming with the Tech 9. Can't find anything for the moment. We'll get a little bit of considerably damage, but not going to be enough to secure the frag. Nexa down to 58. And Exsto just going to hold up for the moment here. Can't really do too much else as they make their way over towards mid. Versa with the AWG gets one. Will eventually be traded out. Nexa has to make the rotation over because I don't think the bomb will be coming in via wraps this time around. He's going to go for the A commit here, and this could not work out well for him. As Alex just waits for him to walk straight into his loving arms, gets the frag, gets a free B site to boot. And that should be Exsto pulling off a miracle in the eco.
And this is exactly how it's gone. Every time we've seen it, they pull off some eco, a rush like that, one person hitting an insane shot to bring them back into the game, keeping it competitive at least. This has not been boring Counter-Strike by any means. It's been very exciting. Just non-stop action. That's what you love to see.
Yeah, it's been exciting. It's been interesting Counter-Strike as well. As
to say the least.
Closes back down to five as yeah, exactly. As Ekel gets a B-hopping Spud. Audio safe, but Ekel's just a little bit too sharp for that. As so look for a trade. Alex will be able to get it here. The B side's actually open here. They make a quick rotation. Should be able to get the bomb down in time. They have lost Farslap in the meantime though, but as Maddie S fails the bomb throw, will get the bomb down, however. So CappingTV, so the heat title will get pulled out in rotation. Matty S able to get the trade, but a 3v2 and he is tagged up a little bit, so definitely not ideal. They will smoke out Kitchen, so they can't do too much there. Versa though, will nearly spot out Alex, but he gets the 1-2 lineup. He Exsto just made it too easy for him. Easy defuse. They're only three away from bringing us into a decider.
That decider. Inferno, isn't it?
I think
I'm
it is.
I'm honestly having a brain fart on the maps. These rounds have just melted my brain. And I can't think anymore. I do have the pause time coming up.
Call I Versa, yeah. So, we got up to 3 minutes here for him to figure out what the hell's happening. Although, it will be a quick unpause, so... they're trying to call for attack, but they've, stuffed... So, they have accidentally done the tech ball's timeout, so... All is forgiven, though, in the team chat, so... That's good, at least. But yeah,
good sportsmanship.
I think I see this nearly every VO3. Someone accidentally puts in a tech timeout, but they do it through console, so it turns into a tech, and it's just, you know, it happens. So I think most players are just accustomed to it. But anyways, back to the action at hand here. As I was going to say, why are you crying there? He should be in a lot better spot economically at the moment, but look at that buys. Orcs, they have an MP9 as well onto the Donk. I mean, not at all surprising. He has been rocking that multiple times this evening. Well, I thought they would have had a slightly better buy. Alex has been tagged up a little bit here early on over to Ward's apartments.
I think it might have been a tech pause. Could have been. Because Versa is AFK NCT spawn at the moment.
He is, so, unless this is
appearing.
A...
Or it's a 500
it's
IQ.
Yeah, unless it's higher IQ, but, well, they can't stop the round anyways. Damage has been dealt in a frag as well now, so they're a little bit too late for that. Two kills quickly taken over towards Alex. And effectively in the 1v5, Exsto will pick up the 8. Unless a Versa comes back and he just memes them all into oblivion. Badonka with his MP9 can't do too much, so...
I think Badonka's just playing Guardian Angel at this point. Because Versa has that AK, such a valuable weapon.
And all the util as well, along with Deagle. So he is back, however, so won't have to play Guardian any longer. They are going to try for it, I suppose. But Manny, yes, with the perfect line. Doesn't get the timing right, however. Smoke will be thrown out, but Versa quickly drops. Badonka can't do much, and that will be the 8 over to Exsto.
Slightly questioning why Versa even went out there.
Yeah, I mean, at that point, you would just think, okay, just stay silent for the rest of the round, and hopefully they don't
hold
come
on
near,
to your weapon.
But... Oh. Yeah, but he's thrown it, and why are you crying now onto an ego here? Deagles and a P250. So Exsto looking to try and come back as, that was Versa there. Yeah, right in the back takes down... Poro Badonka, 239 HP, so not the most ideal start to the eco as Alex gets a free frag.
Quick little easy headshot for him as well. It's now a little bit of action going on in middle. XR finally landing the headshot at long range with the P250. But the B site wide open in the hands of Alex still as he's going to pick up a second. And trade's going both ways now as... AK is in the hands of Versa, and we've seen the kind of aim, the kind of accuracy he has with this weapon. Bomb making its way straight back to T-spawn. Far slap finding one for himself. And still lurking right here in the ramp. Danger able to find one as Versa left in the 1v2. AK, one flashbang to his name. Does have the armor to complement it, so don't... Quite doable. Voice left, holding the angle. Be tough to get past. Shots, giving his position away as well. Gonna be Typer. Landing the bullet in the head. Closing out the round and bringing Exsto one round closer. Yet again.
if Exsto is trying to come back once again here. And that's actually the double eco coming out here for Why You Crying. They do pick up a bit of armor and a few nades to work with, but yeah, it's not a lot here for him as Deco comes out in full effect. Exsto does a smidge of damage there, taking a tenth of Alex's health away from him. But yeah, it's not a... not looking ideal for him at the moment, you would have to say. Ekal's gonna go for the fast play, but Spud can't read it in time. That is a very sharp shot. Could find a second as well. Alex has to be so careful, but... oh no! Oh, that could have been disastrous, but somehow gets the frag in time!
What is going
He's gonna put a triple now, but does he not see the second play? Will eventually do so. Takes him a bit longer than he wanted to eventually get the frags, but... he does enough for his team. The bomb has been planted over on the A site. The Donker has been made to look like full, and that will be Exsto heading into double digits.
Not a moment too soon either. We're getting into cunts time here on Mirage. We head into round 24 with Why You Crying still 3 rounds ahead. And Farslap having an absolute fantastic map for himself with 22 kills to his name, 13 deaths. And we're finally seeing a decent buy coming out for Why You Crying. It seems like it's been a few rounds since we saw one.
Indeed, as we do see the MP9 though onto Danger, so not a full buy for Why You Crying here. It will be a very slow round as well here, so... well, slower than what we have seen over the past few, so... Versa, hold up in con, full spot out, and just get fast up after copying 88 points of damage. Excel, or Alex, sorry. Still a fine one, but can't get Luke as he makes his escape over towards the nest, but it's gonna throw the molly down towards connector, so no one can go for the wide peak. Versa... still very low, has made his way over towards Ticket, as Typer, the only person over towards Con, Danger gets the free frag over at that, the exit, yes?
Yeah, that is such an uncommon angle too, because you saw, I believe it was Maddie walking out, looked over to the right, over towards that little bench on the balcony. Nobody hardly ever plays over to the left. That was great positioning with that MP9. And it was just a one and done, so once he got the one, there wasn't anybody else there, but he had to bail out either way. Because he would have been found.
He's going to get the frag there. Bomb will be planted as well, but will eventually be taken down by Ekal. Danger makes a rotation into Con, will pay dividends for him as he brings it into a 1v2. Ekal finishes it off. He gets himself a 2 foul along with his remaining teammate. And just like that, Why You Crying? 2 away.
But we did see them on 14 last map as well.
Look what happened.
Exsto ended up taking it out. Hopefully we don't see the same kind of upset here. I would like to see map 3, especially on Inferno, because that is such a storied map 3. We've seen so many legendary matchups on that. And... teams always seem to play best on Inferno map 3. Doesn't matter what level of CS you're at.
No one can escape Inferno. But this is gonna be interesting as we do go there, as we do see Alex picking up the opener of the 25th. Might be looking for a second as well. Ooh, gets it nicely as Versa unable to get the frag. Eventually traded out from Nexa. He's going for the one. Can't get the second. We'll eventually get the nade out. That should confirm the death for Typer. Into a 3v2 now as Danger able to find Maddie. Yes. While making his way over towards Tetris along at the rotation as well. So Nexa has to be very careful playing opposite the exit from Palace, but just holding the line for the moment. Doesn't want to over aggress through Tetris onto site, but there's no one really looking onto site proper. Danger probably the only one, but he's more guarding his teammate over towards PAL exit, so... this is going to be risky, but fast up with the AWP, sharpest ever, able to find one, but we'll send out the smoke as well as Molotov will force danger off his line on planet. 40 seconds now remain as... Ooh, Spartan very lucky to be alive there. But 2v2, two players... Sorry, three players now on low health. Fast life goes to one too many peaks. The Donker can't get the shot, just like that. It's a one-shot game, Spud. Can't get the frag. Trying to stay alive as long as he can. Danger's going to go for the fake spots out. Won't be enough. Goes in a second. And that will be enough to bait out his opponent. 15 on the board for Why Are You Crying. They're on map point. And Exsto, they need 5 now just to bring it to OT.
Definitely. And it's definitely doable for Exsto. If you would have told me that we would have seen 30 rounds on train and this many rounds on Mirage, this many rounds on Mirage is not unheard of at any level because it is such a aim dually map, and all these players have fantastic aim. So for it to be going this far, not very surprising. What is surprising is the MAC-10 in mid. At top mid.
Yeah, Fastlap just can't afford his orb, so he's gone for the next best. A bit of server lag there, so that could be the telling point. Hopefully we will be able to see the conclusion of this game this time around, as Ekar whiffs 1-2 shots, will be forced back. Gonna try and focus here over towards Pal, but we'll just decide to smoke it off. Just like that, the A-site under lock and key for the moment here. Why You Crying can't do too much about that, so they're going to have to try and break it open. Ekar, though, should be able to find Spud very easily. Can he get the second? No, he can't. Versus though with the trade danger, quickly takes down Alex. The game is falling apart here for Exsto, as they might be forced on it to a decider. The bomb's making a rotation over towards the A-site. And just like that, it's all up for Exsto now. They need a miracle. Can they do it? Fast up with the MAC-10. He's going to rush straight on over towards...
What?
The same spot. He's able to find Typer. One Typer as well. Takes down Versa. This game might not be over just yet here as Madonka, though. He swings for one. Can he get the second as well? Typer just playing safe. Will he spot it out? It's a 1-2 Hattie 2 bait from it. Why Are You Crying? And we're off to Inferno here.
Yes, and not a moment too soon, as that is a 16-10 victory coming out there for Why You Crying. They absolutely needed that as well. After that 30-round marathon on train, they bring it back. Don't give up. And we're headed off to Inferno. Any afterthoughts there of that Mirage game?
To be honest, I thought it was there for Exsto, but Paradox, or sorry, Why Are You Crying, were able to shut the door on them quite nicely, so they definitely improved off train, where definitely did feel like I was just having a bit of a laugh, so it's good to see him build up on that, and hopefully in the decider, well, we get to see him at their full flight.
Definitely, we are going to take a quick break, but we will be back very shortly on Inferno for the last map of this semi-final matchup between Exsto and Why You Crying. So we'll see y'all very shortly. Stick around. All right, and we are back here. We are actually going to give you the knife round because it actually kind of matters. And it's going to start off with Ecole stabbing his teammate right in the butt.
As a tradition.
Naturally. You have to poke your teammate a little bit. It's going to be straight down mid. His SPD is going to give one, but trade it out right immediately. Danger grabbing one. Matty S with the trade, and it's down to Alex in the 1v3. He's going to get taken down by Danger, and it's going to be Why You Crying with their choice of side, most likely going over to that CT side.
Yep, it's what you do expect here on Inferno, and they do so as well, so we'll get this decider underway immediately. If you're wondering why we're at the decider, well, 16-14 at the first over to Exsto on train, and then 16-10 for Why You Crying, also known as Paradox on Mirage. So onto the decider here, winner goes to the grand final. Well, we don't know who's the first team in that grand final just yet. We'll be either USA or Zoom Zoom. We'll find out soon enough, hopefully. Their semifinal is going, or they're going on as well at the same time, so we'll hopefully bring you the update as soon as we can. But for now, opening frag over to Danger, taking our fast lap over towards Nana. It's gonna, they are gonna move up, however, here, Exsto. We'll be taking top control. Gonna try and continue to push on here, but in saying that, Matty S able to get the sneaky play over towards the A site, so can he deal with the Julies though? Nope. He can never deal with the Julies. He's still got a few more bullets to work with, but he quickly wastes two, decides for the reload. He's going to make the rotation up towards the valve, but he's just going to get caught out, punished for his transgressions. And just like that, into a 3v3, 48 seconds remaining on the clock.
So I did just check out the bracket, and it didn't look like Gusha. Am I pronouncing that right? Gusha?
Gusha? Suppose you are.
I'm not sure how to pronounce it. They did win 2-0, so it will be the winner of this map versus them in the grand final. We'll probably learn how to figure out how to pronounce their name before that.
Indeed, as I think it was a nice play there from Typer to recognize that there might be a boost over towards
Bursa!
Yeah, cut out, but oh my god, that is Bursa doing Bursa things a bit around to get himself the last three kills, and just like that, Why Crying? They were in a tricky spot, and then Versa said, nah, free round, gets the win, and they'll be 1-0 up in the decider.
What? Wow.
Yeah.
Three fast kills. That third one did not even look like it landed at first glance, but the server said otherwise. And the full deagle buy now coming out for Exsto, and against these MP9s, it could be quite difficult.
Indeed, as we will see.
Especially with Badonka flying around corners.
Here. Yep, he gets a quick 2-fer, makes that a 3-fer, next round in danger, adding to the total as well. So the economy building up here for Why Crying as they quickly go 2-0 up.
Now we see the guns coming out full buy on the side of Exsto after that absolutely eco shutdown. Smart move from them just to get the deagles and try and get anything they can. And once again, we see the rush straight down mid with these SMGs and down banana. As kills going both ways so far, Typer has something to say about that. All of a sudden, Nexar left 1v4. MP9 in hand.
Yeah, they went for the MIP rush again, and that has just failed quite spectacularly here. So, Nexa does have the deagle. 4x3, maybe?
I think that was 4x3. Definitely.
Yeah. That was such an odd kill. As Alex should get this last frag. That'll be Exsto's first up, but yeah. They went for the rush again. They thought Exsto's economy was still being the taller, but it's the third round. Their economy was nice and healthy. They pick up their first in the rifles, and now Why Crying are going to buy up in response. Looks like we're going to have for a double AWP setup here, so not a bad play. Versa though. Has he DC'd again?
No, he's here. Just in time as well, as he barely able to get that MP9 in his hands.
gets it in time. Zeke, he'll get the opener. Can he find a second? No, he can't. But Donka has to play recover. Will eventually get the second kill. As just like that, it's so stuck in a 2v4. But quick late trade there for Farsight. We'll give him an opportunity. Although these shoulder peaks reverse will do damage, but not enough. Now, it's all up to next to here. Should be able to find one. Can find a second as well. We'll get it. Eventually, that'll be why you're crying onto a third.
And that shot from Eagle on mid, it wasn't like insane. It was just clean. A clean, solid little flick off to the left. And sometimes it's not about the flashy 180 flicks. Sometimes you just like to see those nice, easy, clean flicks. That shot made me feel good. I think we just saw another instance of 4x3.
Yeah.
We also saw Nexar get his head absolutely ripped off by a Tech 9. No, indeed, these things happen.
Yeah, these things definitely happen as Alex will eventually get the bomb down here. My model's acting a little bit odd here, so hopefully that won't distract me much. And actually, Ekal he's not even showing his gun for me, so yeah, this is going to be interesting to see, but he's going to try to get the shot off. We'll eventually get the kill. Alex and Farsight though, trying some responses, but here comes danger with the MV9. Fires one, fires a second, by crying up to four.
Once again, we see the strong start coming out from Why You Crying. Will they be able to keep up this momentum, though, and prevent the comeback here from Exsto? And now that I've said it, I've caster cursed it. So now we're going to see a quadruple overtime here.
Why do you do this?
You know, sometimes I just like to cause a little bit of chaos in life. It makes me feel better about myself.
Understandable, but, look, understandable at the same time, just why? As Maddie S able to get the kill there on to Nexar. The Donker looking for some retribution. I won't be able to get it just yet here. We'll be pushed out of his position next to the boiler. Quite easily, actually. Didn't put up much of a resistance as Verso's being spotted out. Donker finds one, but spotted with Illy traded out. We'll get the nice little double though before doing so.
Not the knife! Maddie!
Oh, yeah, he's Maddie. Just being punished. He is just being given.
Oh, Maddie, why you gotta be a bully?
Yeah, a little bit disgusting there for Maddie, but that will mean Exsto picks up a second round here, so maybe your very, very sad words will come to fruition here. We might see that quadruple overtime. Actually, that's not sad. That's actually gonna be quite thrilling. Especially on Inferno, where both teams are just going to try their hearts out and, well, yeah, you never know, this might turn out to be a very interesting map.
It is, and one thing I always love about watching Inferno games, like, it's been in the map pool forever in its current iteration, and just in Counter-Strike forever, so everybody knows Inferno. But somehow, teams still pull off these cheeky plays that leave you scratching your head like, how did this happen? Like, for example, Nexar just walked through a smoke next to Typer and is now down banana. They have no clue that he's here. And he's dropped the bomb at his feet.
Versa will eventually fall though, but yeah, Versa able to pick up the quick too far. The bomb is going to be rotated on towards the B site, so I'm going to where it was originally intended. Typer just holding the line there, making sure there's no cheeky players coming out from danger. He might actually peek, and he'll get the kill as well. So, just like that, Exsto get three on the trot here. And two on the trot, and they're looking to try and tie things up once again.
Another thing I'd like to note. Right now on the server, everybody is between 4 and 7 kills. So, we really haven't seen any kind of star playing this map so far, and that's another thing I love about Inferno. Everybody knows it, so everybody can kind of work the map to their advantage, put themselves in a position where they can perform and get these kills.
Well, those kills are gonna go towards Spine and Alex, so It's looking good for Exsto at the moment, as, well, why are you crying on the eco? Can't do too much, so we should be tied up at 4 all at the conclusion of the next few seconds. Matty S will be 1-4 though, so it won't be a perfect round for Exsto. Versa, can't do too much with his AK though, so quickly taken down. Exsto ties it up at 4 all. And yeah, this is gonna be a Nova round here for Eco.
Nova. Wasn't able to find anything in the last round. Pushed up in apartments where they got taken down by the AK. Hopefully he can find a little more value with it here in round 9.
As he can.
Absolutely he does.
Just got the kill. $900 for Eco right there in the bank. As Farslap has been forced to go back close towards spawn here. Eco's still rocking the Nova, but he's rotated back on over towards site proper. So pellets will be safe for the moment from getting a couple pellets to the head. But yeah, this is turning out into yet another interesting game here. A few odd buys, a few odd strats. It's working out for both teams though, as we're currently tied up at 4 all. Alex, he should be able to get the peek here, although he decides wisely to quickly fall out as the flash comes through. But, oh no, not again. Surely not. There it is. $1,800 now into the pocket for Eco.
And it's paid for itself.
Yep, it has. He's going to get rid of it now with the $600 profit into his pocket. And, well, 2v4 now here for Exsto. Not looking particularly good for him. Danger should get the swing out eventually. Hopefully we'll get that kill if you are a Biocrying Paradox fan. Although in saying that, he is going to get double peaked, so he's forced to make a run away. But look at Donkar. Mines him up perfectly from Coffin and Biocrying back into the lead.
Not a moment too soon. Their economy was starting to dwindle away, but with that victory, they've managed to get a decent buy back into it, just sacrificing one rifle on Badonka. Onto the MP9, but the full buy is still out from Exsto. Definitely still a competitive round in terms of the economical battle. Both teams struggling though on their back foot of money.
Yeah, the economy not looking too strong for most of the players here. Chicken runs away, tries to survive yet another round here on Inferno. It is gonna be the MP9 once again on towards Badonka. Quite odd after him picking up the onto kills with the M4, but that's how Counter-Strike goes every now and again, I suppose. The bomb's just hovering around towards the back of mid and Nana. Not really sure where they want to take it here, although eventually they are going to move it up. Spud with the bomb will make its way over towards the top of the head. Badonka will get the flash, can only find one fast up as well, taking out Danger. Although saying that, Typer over on the B side, and we get the frag, so 2v4 now. 4 Exsto, we're going to try and make this a 5-4 game.
Next
that second shot! How does he get on the last bullet? We will never know as Versa quickly makes a rotation around. We'll be able to spot our Typer, but can't get the kill! Versa on 100 HP, the only hope left here. 4, why are you crying? In this 10th round, he's completely flashed out. We'll continue to push, however, we'll make his way on it towards side spot, so hasn't been spotted out. Should get the frag here, would think. Easy one for him there. And we're tied up at 5-all once again.
What a shot there from Nexar. In the
pit.
Yeah,
that was nutty.
It put me at a loss for words again. Like, things that just shouldn't work that somehow do. And you're just kind of left standing there looking at the aftermath, confused. Sounds a lot like my high school days, standing around looking confused. Actually, Ecole, all alone with the AWP here on B.
I mean, he has been sharp enough to be trusted holding down the side, especially in a 1v1 where he should have the advantage over the Typer, you would think, if he just lines it up. As Maddie will get a nice flash in for himself. Unfortunately, no one there to receive it, so he'll just gain a little bit of position from that play. As Badonka once again on the MP9, mixed by here for Why You're Crying, as Nexar will be forced out of the HUD area. Look at this, he's onto the firepods here. Spots out one, can't get the frag. He's doing a fair bit of damage, but Alex survives for now. 40 seconds remaining though. Farsaf able to just flick onto Pedonka in time. Typer gets the kill onto Eco as well. The B side's completely open up here. Rotations coming out very quickly from Nexar trying to regain as much control as he can. With 26 seconds remaining, that bomb has to go to B. Rotations are coming through. Typer finds one. B side's completely open here. That should be an easy pump for Exsto. And in a 4v2, some of the players Y-Crying might have health advantages, but this round seems in the back for the T side.
Definitely. And early on already, we see Danger posted up at the bottom of Banana, and Versa just hanging out over in Pit with that AK, holding onto it for dear life. I doubt they will push him, but we might see Farslav go down Banana, trying to save the Zeta would be, and with Danger being so close up with the MP9, could be his demise. But they are actually going to all bail through CT. Hopefully Versa will be able to hold on to this AK. They desperately need it with their economy in its current dead state. Their economy is absolutely wrecked, and Versa's going to get dropped by Spud.
Finds the pixel and takes him down immediately. So Spider quick onto the trigger here, and that will be Exsto into the lead once again.
Slow start here as well, as everybody just kind of poking around for information, throwing that little bit of lurk utility all around, getting all the information they can. Alex gonna get flashed up here top mid, doesn't quite spot anything out, and he's actually taken down Badonka too with the CZ, almost making it a third as well, as but just a little bit quicker on that AK.
Yeah, the AKs will eventually find one kill, but they've lost two of our number, so not sure who's victor in this case as all. Nice timing there for Mikael to get the immediate retribution. Danger gets the kill on the MP9 as well, just like that's all up to Spud. He was sharp before, but can he do it again? Smokes out the smoke. Can't find Danger at the moment, and now he's in danger from being pincered from the other side, so we'll be able to get bombed just down in time. Danger, he's gonna go for the Coffin's play here, so Eco will be the immediate for the moment, but he gets an easy frag, and that'll be why he's crying. Tie things up at 6-all.
And it is Eco recovering that AWP that was dropped in mid. They are at least getting that for consolation, and they have managed to bolster quite a decent economy on both sides, actually, as we're tied in 6-6. Coming into the last few rounds of this first half, and I'm still somewhat in shock of Exsto putting on this impressive of a performance here against what is essentially a MDL light team, because it is not the full Paradox roster, and wow, what a nade.
It is Paradox minus one.
Yeah, I think I can get away with calling it Paradox Light.
Yeah, no, that's exactly what they are, so yeah, it's not the,
Paradox with a sprained ankle.
Paradox with a minor calf injury, but, anyways.
Yeah. Because it even...
will... There you go.
Even though one sub that is not actually part of the Paradox roster is still performing. So it would even be something as simple as a jammed finger at this point.
DMX proved himself to be somewhat reliable. 7-9, so it's like pretty respectable job, all things considered. Eco looking to try adds the pain for Exsto, however, as well, here they will find one. We'll get traded out. Netza, though, getting his own little trade happening as fast up. We'll be able to get the ball down. So, 3v2 here. Medesh should be able to find Mercy, you would think. Gets an easy frag with to the head. Just like that. 2v2 here. Not looking too good for Why You're Crying. As Dangerous caught in a bit of a tricky spot here as well as top mid. We'll eventually start to move out. This is sort of all on Badonka here. He needs to get that frag on it too fast up and try and swing onto Matty. Both players quite low, affecting on half HP or less as Badonka begins his play. Danger trying to find the 1-2, but Matty, yes, he has just popped out, haven't been able to flush him out. And look at that, Exsto back in the lead.
It's kind of put Why You're Crying in a rough situation as three of their players under 3,000. It's looking like they are forcing up into this, though. At least on E-Cole with that Nova. Once again, and he's actually bringing it towards Banana this time. Oh, takes the nade to the chest as well. He finds one.
There we go. Can he get the second? We won't find out soon enough, though, because he's just around, although he's just survived on 20 HP, so unless they make a dangerous play.
Nexar!
Shouldn't be able to get the kill, but yeah, Nexar's just got himself a nice little headshot there. And well, once again, Exsto, they seem to be in a good spot, and then that Nova comes out, and well, they just don't know what to do. Saying that though, nice shot there on to Versa there. Danger, trying to find some retribution, he's just going for the quick play, will be flush out. It's all up to Eco now. 20 HP, a Nova, and a Dream. Also has a Molotov delivery, so there is that. Might be able to flush outside just a little bit as he finds one.
No!
He finds a second! Surely not. Surely he's not gonna do it. He gets a dink on. It's a one-shot game. But eventually, flush out brings an end to the madness. And Exsto will go 8-6.
Eco, why do you have to do it to him like that?
I mean, he didn't do it to him. He only got a few frags. He didn't get the round.
Yeah, but the money is such an important factor coming into this last round because it determined that he could get that AWP and utility.
Yeah, his economy was nicely helped out there by the amount of frags he got. Over. I think that was a 3 or 4 of us, so at least $2,700 to block it as Alex, he's got the word.exe going there, just flicks onto Ecol and who's just dead set sent him into another universe. But quick retribution coming out from Why You Crying, able to get the quick 2 on the drop. We'll put him into a nice little spot, but most of their players now hovering over towards the A site here. Flash sent out towards top mid to try and keep him there. As Versha not moving over just yet, we'll just hold over towards the vines. As Molotov comes through here, rotation immediately called for by Danger, who needs to try and pog out here on this AUG. Finds one, might be able to find a second as Spud now left in a tricky spot here. Has to be Guardian Angel by his teammate though. Badonka just can't get the kill in time, Spud. Able to find some retribution here, brings it into a 2v2, but fast up onto 1 HP. Donker, though, very low indeed. Onto 20, next on to 39 as well. So, every possible for Exsto to take the lead 9-6 as Nexa just makes his way slowly onto site along with his teammate here. Might not be the best, of course, considering they have 100 HP opponent to deal with in Spud. Although, things come through and it does not work out. They will line it up to get the double. And just like that, Exsto lead in to the halftime break, 9-6.
And this is the first time we've seen Exsto in the lead at the half, so maybe they can pull up some magic on this CT pistol, bring up some magic on, now I got this, scoreboard bug. Thanks for that.
Well, they've been kind in how they're giving out the scoreboard bugs tonight, as, it gets on the way here. Most kills on the server, not surprisingly, over towards Spud. He was popping out from a fair few rounds here, as it will be a fairly quick rush up to take down Alex, who was just brought out over towards Balk. So Apps Control coming straight on over to the side of Paradox. They're going to try and push as quickly as they can here. Fast side, I'm able to get the first shot here. Has been spotted out because of it, but Matty S able to get one. Needs to find a second one. Be able to, and just like that, they begin to fall left, right, and center, all up to Typer. Is over towards the top mid. This opening round in the bin, you would have to say for it. So then saying that he finds one. Can he find a second? Might be able to kick this round a lot of the off in a prime position. Will eventually
get
the knife. And that will be the second pistol on to why you're crying.
I do apologize that Counter-Strike is still broken.
Understandable.
The greatest thing ever.
Always the greatest thing with Counter-Strike as we get on the way here for the next round.
Is it a feature at this point?
Probably is, knowing a good old Volvo, but anyways, it will be actually quite a decent buy there for Xplexa, all things considered. They pick up the scout, they pick up an MP9 as well. They have a bit of util to work with to just try and slow down their opponents as XL. Just trying his best to get the kill, won't be able to for the moment. Ecarl will be safely tucked behind sandbags. As we're not going to just try to spot out here towards apartments, can't find anyone for the moment. So, just playing nice and passively here, not trying anything ridiculous. A splash comes through, push starts to come out from wide. You cry, a Typer. Unable to get the first shot, will be punished for Adversa as well, taking down Alex. So that's the B side all but opened up for him. Spot the last play left standing here, but he's caught behind the coffin, so he can't do too much. And he will eventually wide swing through, get the kill via the wall. And just like that, Exsto will lose the second round in the second half, and you would think third as well, as an Eco is their destiny here. But now, why are you crying? 1-2-8.
Slap actually able to find one. Maddie with another on this post plant, and they do get the AWP, and he's going to pick another one up. 2v2 now, and he's being pressured. Far slap. Excuse you. Okay. But Maddie still gets it. Picks himself up a hat trick in the end there. Post plant.
Jesus Christ.
And they get the AWP.
Yeah, third on AWP, it has to be a hero gun. There's no way they can get a good enough buy around here, so they will upgrade a few pistols, but nothing else. But yeah, this is quite a boon for Exsto. Forces while you're crying, honored to a half buy as well. AKs and Mac 10s being in the call, but Matty S, oh, a bit too much confidence there, need to play passive. And while that AWP immediately given back on over to their opponents here, Spud. Trying to find a frag that isn't his team there, as he's able to find one. Typer will get the quick trade as well, but bomb's being planted. Next guy gets the quick frag as well to probably seal out the rounds. And well, after a few shenanigans, we should be tied up at 9 all in the next few moments.
Like we're seeing a cheeky little boost here coming out. Yep, they reverse boosted onto the flower pot. Not something you really see that often. It is caught out though. And it is going to be why you kind of tying it back up at 9 as Badonka just running through takes one down. Farslap is able to trade that out though with a nice little headshot there onto Badonka. I swear this AWP has changed teams like 4 rounds in a row now. Oh, can I... Feels like every team has had their hands on this.
Yeah, the orbs have been very powerful weapons so far in this series, as Exsto will go for their own AWP bomb. Badonka now being played just a little bit slow out of the gates, but will eventually get the move on. As Exsto try and regain that lead they've lost over the past few rounds, Versa will come a bit of nade damage early on. Ecarl holding the line from the bottom of ramp, but can't find anyone there. No one foolish to peek at the moment, so just gonna try and take control over towards the top. We'll be able to do so. And now we're just gonna have to go for a somewhat quick play here through the Molotov versus burning through Chris. Somehow survives, somehow gets the kill. He gets a second as well through the smoke. That is unbelievable from Versa. As the bomb quickly goes down, 4v3, one player very low, although he should be playing nice and safe. And look at this, Nexar, he's on that rotation. He's heading up behind an NCT spawn. This could close around now quite nicely. Finds one, and just like that, Ecol finds fast stuff as well. Matty S can't do anything except a few bullets. Just like that, why are you crying? Five rounds straight, they're back into the lead.
What a brilliant position from Nexar there. I would have liked to see the trigger discipline, but that player just turned around at the right moment, right as he came around the corner, so he had to take him out. Would have been nice to see that lineup, though. As we're looking at the scoreboard, we see some fantastic stats coming out. Especially looking at the utility damage, Typer with 202 thus far, 14 enemies flashed on him. 18 on the side of danger for Why You Crying. ADR wise, it's equal on top of the board with 94 at the moment. We are heading now into round 20, getting into the last, what could be the last third of this, or what is actually, I apologize. The last third of this series. Exsto on that bit of a broken buy, they might try and just nade stack down banana and down mid, which can be a very brutal for a T side to deal with. That's danger already down, 24 HP to his name.
Yeah, danger very low now at the moment as he has to, well, he's only got the Mac 10. He has a fair bit of utility to use up as well, so it's not the end of the world if he falls out. He will eventually fall off, but he gets the second through the smoke as well. The CZ doing what it needs to do here. Spots out another, but I don't think he spotted out Bursa, so still have one player left unspotted over towards logs, so looking not bad for Wirecrying at the moment, all things considered. But saying that, they might just lose yet another eco round, which would have to be quite tilting for them. They have lost a few too many, to say the very least, as
he's going to catch on Nexar.
Yeah, oh yeah, indeed. This is going to be very tilting for Nexar. He thought he could sneak around twice, won't be able to, and just like that's all up to Versa and Ecol to just try and brute force away into side. Won't be able to. Typer finds one. Ecol on the orb. It's been flashed to the end of the day, and we're tied back up a 10-all for Exsto.
What a 4K bud there. Picking up three with the CZ. One of them just completely random through the smoke. And then that last spray down onto Ecol with the AWP. Manages to pull it out and tie it back up. 10 rounds apiece. And as I was saying before, Inferno, one of the most competitive maps for map 3. It's been neck and neck the entire time.
Indeed, the gaps have not been too big in this series so far. As Fast Clap, Nose goes down Versa, spot as well. He's on a tear, this man. He gets yet another kill. Donka will eventually shut him down. It's a 3v2 for the side of Exsto, though. Donka, he doesn't know that. He's just getting the frags. Will eventually be taken down by Fast Clap. That's what I want to see, Cole. Gets the bomb down, but oh, that is sharp, sharp pulp work there from Fast Clap. Quickly takes down Ecol and Exsto back into the lead once again.
The lead has changed so many times this map. This is an exciting game in Counter-Strike.
Oh yeah, it is. This is some good Counter-Strike we're seeing here. Both teams really, really are showing their hearts out here. This is what I said earlier. Inferno's saw the map where you have to be on the top of your game because your opponents, they know this map like the back of their hand, so they are going to be very, very hard to overturn if, well, you start slacking off. So, yeah, looking pretty good for the moment here for Exsto, you would have to say. Picks up quite nicely. Alex able to get the first from Flower Pots. Going to try and get the second. We'll be able to as well. Throws out the nade. Ecol will lose just a sliver of damage. Just Nexar, last man standing, finds one. Needs the miracle play. Won't be able to. Exsto up by two.
They're starting to really build on that CT economy, which can be rough to recover from once you get in that deficit. And we see the bit of a broken buy coming out for Why You're Crying. They do have a lot of utility, though. But the weaponry, not quite there, not quite able to take some of these duels that they might like to, just due to that, as Typer taking down one of their AKs. The Eagle on Eagle getting taken out by the grenade. And Spud playing that perfectly, waiting, kind of almost baiting that they are going to peek his teammate. That's playing the angle absolutely perfectly, and all of a sudden it's a 2v5.
Yeah, started off with some good nade damage, and then it just all fell away there for White Crying. So, fast up, just spots out danger, we'll get the feet. Immediately spotted out. Spud should be able to get the last kill. Oh, but Onka though, he gets some retribution there, but he's on HP. He is one bullet away from death. Files up will continue to add to his tally, and another free for Rahim. Exsto only three away now from spruiking the upset.
So we talked before the match about expectations. I thought it was going to be a quick 2-0. I have eaten my words multiple times at this point. And feel dumb kind of about it. But you know, these things happen, and I love to see it happen, because that means that teams are actually playing fantastic Counter-Strike and not just throwing, almost. As much as I hate to say that word.
Yeah, it's been good to see, especially from Exsto. They have really been performing quite well, so yeah, they definitely deserve to be in the winning position at the moment. Why are you crying? They have started to turn up here, but they've just been outplayed at the moment. T-side, they've really struggled, it seems. Haven't been able to find too many players to work with here in World Typer. Oh, this could be dangerous. Can't get the quick pick in time. Maddie will be very late. Water Molotov, but we'll find one. Doesn't realize all the second. Oh, nearly gets it in time, but Versa able to get the kill. It's going to be a 3v3. And look at that Eagle from behind coming in from Archers. Takes him down. And just like that, 4 HP Blazer coming out as Spud finds one. Where's the second frag? They need to get it. We'll eventually find Versa. Spud unable to take down Nexa. No util to flush him out, so this is going to be hard. He finds first with the orb. Can't get the flick. Has to go for the Deagle. Can't do it. Spud gets the kill. Has the kit. Gets the defuse. 2-0 for Exsto.
What? What a performance they've put on, because they lost the first four rounds of this half, which had Why You Crying in the lead at 10-9, and now they have mounted a comeback just two rounds away from series point to take them to the grand final here of WAN-Slide.
Yep, WAN-Slide 2.0, the final grand finalists might be decided in a few moments. If you don't know GUSA, that's how I think we pronounce it, but we could be very wrong on that, have won their semi-final 2-0, so their first team through. That team contains Crags and the like. So this should be compared to a grand final no matter what, as Ecole able to take out Matty S, going a bit of an imposter mode there, although Typer able to quickly get some trade action going. Now into a 4v4. Not looking too good here, you would have to say. Well, particularly for Why You're Crying, they're bottled back up once again here. They can't really get a push out going. They have to try and brute force their way through here as Typer shuts down whatever remaining presence they had over towards the top. And they decided, you know what, screw that. We're going to go over towards B. Going to be a very crucial B play as well here, because the economy not looking particularly good. Why You're Crying, if they lose this, a couple of their players are going to be forced on to Mix or even an Eco buy, so it's crucial they pick up this round and they begin the push here. Fast up able to find one, but able to do a bit of damage, but can't get the kill. And it will be a 3v3 retake coming out for CT side. Definitely hard, but definitely doable as well. As Molotov comes through here, Typer flushes out just behind the blue barrels. Danger. Just inspecting his weapon. We'll get out of it just in time as Flash comes through. Alex gets caught out, but still gets the kill. First of one to one. Gets the second as well! And just like that, it's all up to Fast Slap here. Both of his opponents, though, over towards the other side of Nana, but eventually Versa gets a nose code. 3 on the trot for him, and why are you crying? They are still in this game.
They're definitely not crying, and if they are, it is tears of joy after pulling that round for themselves. And Versa with the AWP doing absolute heroics. Now, it's a bit of a... not, I don't want to say a bad buy, but it is not the best weaponry here for Exsto. Should be a very quick sight take coming out for Why You Crying wherever they do decide to go. Letting Nexar kind of lurk over towards the apartments. They appear to be setting up for that B hit. And as I say that, start bailing out, coming back towards mid. I do like Exsto just playing this very passive, playing the close angle with Maddie as they
E-Cole
finding two.
And next result adds to the pain. Spider able to find E-Cole at the very least, but just like that, Exsto, who are on the Eco, mind you. They're doing damage, but might not be enough to pick up the 26 as Fast Up will eventually be taken down. He had a bit of utility as well to work with, so that will be lost on the economy. But now, it's all up to Typer here. Might be able to pick up a gun at the very least. Top mid is undefended, so he can just pick up a gun and run for the hills. But he's going to go for it here. I mean, I suppose why not? There's opportunity to kneecap the economy even more on his opponent's side, but the Donka has got the line. Should give you an easy frag for him there. Because of the spray, it does whiff, but the second's head just needs the one bullet. 12 up for Why You Crying.
Now we see Why You Crying mounting the same kind of streak that Stowe started off with. Just a little bit of heroics, one good play from one player, completely shifting the mood. Getting them back in the winning mindset. The double op setup once again coming out on the side of Exsto. Will it be able to find anything over here towards top of Nanoport? Bart Slapper, it's gonna be E-Cole. Once again, straight through the smoke and Badonka!
Badonka is just dead set finesse type around the server there, and that he has to leave some retribution. My DK will eventually get the kill there. Spud is forced on the quick rotation now. Spud out DK. He's going to try and get the frag. We'll be able to beat out the shoulder peeking DK. A bomb once again planted here. Why are you crying? It's been very crucial for him to get these bombs down because they've been so good in the post play. It's danger. Just gonna hold the line, knows he doesn't have to peek into anything. We'll get the flash, but Spider's timed that to perfection here. And we're into a 2v2 rotation pass up eventually coming through here. He's being a little bit slow, however, as flash will start to pop out here. Next up, holding on the boxes, but yeah, time's just ticked away here. No real chance for Exsto to go for it. So they're just gonna keep the orb in the M4. We're gonna save it. Not a bad call. So they still have one round lead here, but Why Are You Crying? Starting to come back once again. Exsto, they're on the cuffs of victory, but the door might just get slammed shut by their opponents.
Very doable on the side of Why You're Crying. Bit of a rough economical situation. Get their players, four of them, $1,000. There's going to be an upgraded pistol around this AWP and M4. And even Danger kind of having to opt for that MAC-10.
Yeah, I don't have a mess with Carmi, so it's sort of forced on. Like, he could have maybe cheaped out on the Util, but I suppose Util better have. Especially when he can just go aggro like that. But Piper, he only has the USP and he gets the opening kill. Will eventually get traded out by Danger, but Spud now in a perfect spot here to get a trade. But look at that, Versa and Nexa light, throwing those kills to perfection there. One in Nana, one in mid. Will now to grow up here. But this has been what Roblox is, so they're immediately rotating Spud back towards the A site here. Once they go for a violence play, this should be an A hit here. Nexa will be taken down. It's all up to Fast Up, but has under HP, but only has an AWP. Why Are You Crying? Tightens up with the help of the Donka. And just like that, it's another streak coming out for why you are crying. To tie things up.
We're going to 30 rounds again.
Again.
Every map has been at least 25 rounds in this series. This has been one of the most exciting series I have watched to date.
Oh, yeah. I mean, there's been a few what-the-hell moments sprinkled in there, especially in our first map, but... Yeah, both teams, they're fighting their hearts out here. They're leaving no quarter on the server. Especially when there's some pretty bloody good monitors on the line here for the winner for first place. Especially if you're looking for an upgrade, definitely should be going for it here. I mean, those monitors are about $700 each, so... Yeah, definitely a fair bit to be had, even if it's not cash in the pocket. Anyways, 29th round here, out of the 30 we will be seeing in regulation. Danger just looking for an opening, but you two will not mean too much here, as no one's directly peeking up from either Vines or Library. Alex, though, he plays the barrels to perfection, finds one along with Spud, Typer, holds the line, but no one's coming topside, so... Will be a diggity player coming through here, Spud. Just gonna try and hold off the line here, but the Donker has been very sharp. Just wait for the peek from Alex. We'll cop a dink, but not much else. He's still gonna be very useful as Versha. Make sure no one sneaks in from behind. Will be a 3v3, but Spud, the only player on the side for the moment here. Able to find one, can't find the second. Maybe a little bit too hesitant in trying to find Versa. Now into a 2v2 here, though. Typer and pass up. What can they do? Versa can be a sharp man on the AWP. Smoke dissipates. Typer not looking over towards Typer. Here comes Farsight. Able to direct a few bullets over, but Versa holding the line for the moment. Able to find one. Rotates on over to focus on Farsight. Taken down. Wirekind gets 5 in a row. They're on to Serious Point and Exsto. They're choking at the moment. No other way to put it.
There is not. Really, any other way to put it at this point. They needed to show up, and we could see it head out right here and see why you're crying in the grand finals versus GUSA, you said?
GUSA, yes, that's how GUSA. I believe it's pronounced, although if we are wrong, then obviously Twitch chat will give us a bit of a yell, but anyways.
Or we're going to get flamed on Reddit for 6 weeks as the server has a little bit of a hiccup.
That could mean this could possibly be the end, though. We'll find out very, very shortly, however, as there's 80 seconds left on the clock before the bomb has to be planted. And it looks like Paradox, they're just going to be taking the time here. No real rush. They know they're in the driver's seat at the moment. Ecolo, he's a fair bit of help thanks to a Molotov down towards half. As the bomb still hovers around mid, so still plenty of options here for why crying. Or Paradox Light, but well, that's a bad peek from Matty. Yes, easily gets spotted out there and will be taken down. Now, Spud not in the best positions here and will be taken down. That's most of the rifles gone. That's all the rifles gone now for Exsto. It's quickly falling apart from Why Crying. They will might be on the cusp of making the grand final once again. Farsight needs to try and get the damage. Won't be able to. Will be taken down from behind. It's all up to Typer. He's able to find one. But he's about to get flanked out. No, he finds a second as well. He springs it into a 2v1. It's possible for him. It's definitely very possible. But he's going to make the peek. He's peeking straight into two players. Speaking to Eco and Badonka, who have been so darn strong. Badonka eventually finishes it off. GG, well played. Over to the side of Why You're Crying, also known as Paradox Light. They'll be going to the grand final. But they were made to work for it. That's one thing. Known for sure.
And work for it, they did. A very well played game from both teams. It has been a pleasure to watch that game, but we are going to be heading into our grand final here very, very soon. Anything you want to say about that matchup?
Well, the expected team won, but they did not make it easy for themselves. I mean, that probably should have been a 2-0 if they went. Excuse language, but if they weren't dicking about in a train, we probably would not have seen a decider, to be completely honest. They went for a lot of really, they just went for bum rushes when they didn't need to. They went for disrespect buys when they could have just bought safe and got the weapons they needed. So, yeah, they were made to work for it. It's all their own fault, but they got the win, I suppose. So it all works out good in the end.
Does work out. We will be seeing them against GUSA in the grand final here in Landslide, WAN-Slide 2.0, as it is commonly known as well. For now, though, we are going to take a short break, and we will come back with your grand final here on Capping TV and Landslide TV, where they are also broadcasting this match. Once again, I just want to say a thank you to the Landslide team for having us on their channel, broadcasting their match. It has been a pleasure.
Great.
And yes, we will be back very shortly.